Hi everyone, welcome to Chandan Logics. Hope all you guys are preparing well and staying safe at your home. Since we have started our online classes, in this 1 year span of time, we have trained several thousands of students preparing for various competitive exams. If you want to meet our expert faculty team, you can meet our expert faculty team and we are going to come across with best and unique content which will help you to crack your examinations in a smart way. We are going to teach each and every subject very clearly in detail. And we are going to come across with best and smart approaches which will help you to crack your examinations in very short span of time. Our expert faculty team is going to teach you each and every subject very clearly in detail. If you want, you can join our free foundation batch. This free foundation batch, you need not pay any money for this. And in this free foundation batch, you can meet our expert faculty team who are going to teach each and every subject very clearly in detail. If you have any doubts, you can contact us through these numbers. And we welcome you to be part of Chandan Logics. Thank you.
Hi everyone. Welcome back to Chandan Logics. Today, we'll be discussing September 22nd current affairs. And as well as first we'll go through practice sessions. Next we'll move to descriptive session. And here you have to focus that whenever you are mentioning the answers in comment section, so your answers should be correct and as well as you have to maintain consistency, then only your answers will be considered and your names will be announced in top comments. Is it clear? So follow the conditions while you are going through mock test, like we call it as like practice session. Is it clear? So let us start our class, and before going to start our class, if you want to download current affair PDFs, you can join through our Telegram channel. Event link is also provided in description. Once you go through it, so that you can get availability of free PDFs of current affairs on daily basis. And as well as many of you were mentioning in comment section regarding Telugu current affairs, right? So you can go through Chandan Logics Telugu channel. In that, daily we are uploading our current affairs on daily basis in Telugu language. So those who are unaware of that channel, once you go through it today itself, so that every day you can get the availability and access of current affairs. Is it clear? So first we'll look into the question regarding practice questions, whatever we have discussed the topics in our previous class. Is it clear? So first question is regarding about GII, right? Global Innovation Index. So in this Global Innovation Index, what is the rank of India in this 2021? Is it clear? So here you have to concentrate whatever the topics we have discussed, right? That means India stands at certain rank, right? So that is the rank the question is all about. Then you have to focus here, whatever the seven pillars, right? Yesterday we have discussed in our class about the GII, that means Global Innovation Index, seven pillars score for India. Is it clear? So once you revise it, whatever the seven pillars were there, which were considered for score of India. Is it clear? Then if we move to the options, 39, 63, 46 or 54. Next question is regarding important days. So in this important days, you can look into the concept. What is that? Date, theme, objective, right? So these are the major perspective areas you have to focus. Then if we move to the part, actually, the International Week of the Deaf is being observed in which week of the month of September 2021? So read the question twice or thrice so that you can get easily. Is it clear? That means there should not be any confusion in your mind, because you have to concentrate that whether they have mentioned any year or else they have mentioned like every year. Every year if they ask the question, then what is your answer? So if they have mentioned every year, then your answer will be the last Sunday, right, of the, in the month of September, whatever the whole week before it. So that will be considered as International Week for Deaf People. Is it clear? Then if they have mentioned any particular year, so that you have to remember the dates. So here, as we have discussed in our previous class about 2021 week, right? So it falls under which dates? September 21st to 27th, September 20 to 26th, 15th to 21 or 14th to 28th. So here you can get easily also. How? So shall I say? So here you have to focus what is the date of last Sunday in the month of September? Is it clear? That means this date is there, no? You have to concentrate on this as a last Sunday. So once you go through the calendar, so that you can get to know what is the last Sunday date. Then at least before that, wherever the option is there, okay, you can mention the answer. So at least follow these type of tricks. Is it clear? Next, which country has become the 9th member of Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO, right? So this Shanghai Cooperation Organization, before it was only 8 permanent members, and the one which was added newly, that is actually previously it is observer member. What is that? It is observer member. But now even all these 8 permanent member leaders, okay, whatever the countries were there, so those countries leaders decided that about to add this observer member as a permanent member in this SCO. Is it clear? So now that is the question actually, which country has become the 9th member? Is it clear? And sometimes there is a chance to ask you in the vice versa format. That means certain country has recently added in SCO organization, that means SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization. It is 8th member or else 9th, 10th, like that. They'll mention the option in numerical terms also. So concentrate on these two aspects. Next, if we move to options, Afghanistan, Iran, Pakistan, Bangladesh. So if you have a chance to eliminate, at least if you have no previous 8 members, is it clear? Then try to eliminate those, okay? Then whatever the remaining options were there, so select among them. So sometimes you have to follow elimination process, is it clear? So that you can get your answers very quickly. Next, Jimmy Graves passed away recently. He was a professional footballer of which country? Spain, Italy, England or Chile? So here you can see that actually they have mentioned the name of a person and profession of a person, but the question was raised among the country. Is it clear? So while you are going through obituaries, certain person has belonged to which country? Once you even go through the country name, or else you can see some state name also. Next, India and Indonesian Navy participate in third edition of what? So recently, India and Indonesian Navy has going to conduct this third edition of certain exercise, okay? So whenever we are discussing and dealing with the objectives regarding the defense news, right? And as well as if certain we are going through any exercises, maritime or naval exercise, you have to concentrate on the areas like what are the 2 countries, or else you can see like 3 countries or multilateral countries. So how many countries are participating in that exercise, and what is the name of exercise, then what is the purpose to conduct the exercise, then last comes to which edition. It is third edition, right? Next, if we move to the name of the exercise, is all about the question, Simbex, Varuna, Malabar or Samudra Shakti. Next, Global Innovation Index is released annually by which organization? As I have said you, while we are discussing about ranks and reports, is it clear? So certain report has released by whom? Even indexes also. So organization is very important area. Is it clear? So the perspective areas in which you have to focus, first you have to get an idea. Then if we move, this Global Innovation Index is released annually by which organization? World Economic Forum, International Monetary Fund, World Intellectual Property Organization, or United Nations Development Program, UNDP, right? Or else WIPO, right? Then if you can see this IMF. So sometimes there is a chance that at least a part of this question, just you know the full forms of these words, right? So that if they ask you like what stands for WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization, then what stands for IMF, International Monetary Fund, like these areas also you have to cover parallelly. Is it clear? Then try to mention the exact answer for this. This GII was released by which organization? So with this, we have done with our practice session. Now we'll be moving into our descriptive session. The first topic we'll be covering under International Current Affairs, and that is about Canada. So recently, Justin Trudeau wins his third term as the Prime Minister of Canada. So first we have to cover the static part regarding Canada, right? So Canada capital is Ottawa and currency is Canadian dollar. And Canada is a country in North America. Is it clear? Then now we have to move to the Prime Minister part, right? So recently you can see his image also here, who has recently appointed Justin Trudeau, wins his third term as a Prime Minister of Canada. Actually he is from a Liberal Party, right? So this Liberal Party, and his age is of 49 years old. Actually if you see the history of him, in the year 2015 first he has become as a Prime Minister, and in 2019, and now it is 2021. So you have to focus that third term, right? So first term, second term, and now it is third term. Is it clear? And also he is serving as now 23rd and current Prime Minister of Canada. Is it clear? 23rd and current Prime Minister of Canada, and his term is actually third term. Is it clear? So if we move to the part, actually after his party won on the 2021 parliamentary elections on September 20 of 2021, then he has actually, Justin Trudeau is in power since 2015. Just now I have discussed first term, second term and third term. These are the three important years. And now you have to see about 2021. On September 20 is won the elections, right? Then Trudeau's Liberals were leading election in 157 seats, exactly the same number whatever they have received in the last term, that means in 2019. And as well as you can see, 13 short of 170 needed for majority in the House of Commons. So as we have said that in the House of Commons, out of, you can see, 170 needed for a majority. So who will be majority, and that person will be elected as the Prime Minister. And Prime Minister is a head, right? So here you can see now about the Justin Trudeau. Is it clear? And this is his third term. What are his previous terms also? Just you have to know as a part of history. Is it clear? Next, if we move to state news. Assam set up tea park at Kamrup district's Chayagon. So here mainly what is actually Assam famous for? Assam is famous for tea, right? Many of you has known, right? So then if we move to the part, actually this is a tea garden, and this will have rail and as well as port connectivity. That means majorly they are focusing towards innovation and branding of Assam tea. Is it clear? So this is the main objective to set up this tea park at Kamrup district's Chayagon. Then moving to the Assam, right? What is the capital of Assam? Dispur. Is it clear? Next. So here you can see there is also the rail, port connectivity, cargo and warehouse amenities. So their main objective is that processing the facilities like tea grinding, blending, packaging and other utility services under one roof. So that is the main objective to set up this tea park. Okay, all these services will be done under one roof. And previously, whether it was, if you see, this tea gardening will be there, right? So that tea garden companies using the garden lands, okay, for plantation of sesame, agar and or selling of the tea estates. But now the minister of this state has said that tea garden owners cannot sell off their estates, okay? So they should not sell off their estates. Instead they have to focus on this plantation of tea, right? So this is the main objective, because they want to focus on the innovation and branding of Assam tea. And as well as they cannot sell off their estates, and as the leased land still belongs to Assam government. That is the main objective. What is the reason here? That law lands, whichever were they, that were still belongs to Assam government. And he has said that the owners of these tea gardens should not sell their off, but instead they can focus towards this branding of Assam tea. Is it clear? So you can see in Assam also, like, there will be less employment generation will be, right? So they are focusing towards major of the employment for even youth. And as well as, like, in these areas they have to more be developed, okay? So they are concerned towards different sectors, whatever they, at least in their availability, they are coming up with the new ideas. Next, if we see about Uttar Pradesh government to set up electronic park. Here CM Yogi Adityanath led Uttar Pradesh government has created a proposal to develop an electronic park. Actually, in this electronic part, this is mainly to promote the electronic industry. What is the main objective? To promote electronic industry. So they have set an electronic park, and that is along the Yamuna Express Industrial Development Authority area. So in this area, they have set up this electronic park. And actually, the park is proposed to be developed in the area of 250 acres. So focus on this numerical part. How many acres? 250 acres of the Yeda near Jewar Airport, and as well as national and international companies manufacturing mobile phones, even TVs and like laptops and other systems like which were related to electronic devices and accessories will establish their units in that park. So this is the main objective. So their focus is on what? Their focus is to promote the electronic industry. So they can establish their units in this electronic park. Is it clear? So in 250 acres, they are going to set up this electronic park. So in this electronic park, all like certain electronic devices, what were the units? So even international and national companies also set up their units in this park. Okay. So with this, in that state, they will be going to promote their electronic industry, right? And as well as, if you see, this new electronic park will be built at an investment of around rupees 50,000 crores, and as well as generate the employment for thousands of local youth. So you can see here, obviously, whenever there is a certain factory or industry, right? So in that, what will be the benefit? The local youths can get employment, right? So this is the step of Uttar Pradesh government, that is to create the employment for local youths by promoting this electronic park. Is it clear? Next, you can see about the static part regarding Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh capital is Lucknow, and Anandibhen Patel is governor and chief minister is Yogi Adityanath. Next, if we move to appointments, Air Marshal V.R. Chowdhury appointed as new IAF chief. So Indian Air Force, right? So Indian Air Force, this is the main mission of Indian Air Force, is actually to secure the Indian airspace and as well as conduct the aerial warfare during the conflict. Is it clear? So this is the main object to set up this Indian Air Force. This is one of the armed forces of India. Now if we move the static part of Indian Air Force, IAF, actually this was established in the year 1932, India, and 8th October, and headquarters is at New Delhi. Is it clear? First we have to cover the static part. And now for this IAF, recently Vice Chief of Indian Air Force Air Marshal V.R. Chowdhury, the full name is Vivek Ram Chowdhury, has been appointed as a next Chief of Air Staff. Is it clear? So as we have discussed that about Indian Air Force, right? So for that, the next Chief Staff is V.R. Chowdhury. Next, if we go through the sector, that means while we are dealing with appointments, so for which the person has recently appointed, right? Then we have discussed about that, right? That means IAF, Indian Air Force. The static part has finished with that. Then we'll be moving to the person. Actually, who is the person? What are his achievements previously? And why that person has been selected as the next chief staff for this IAF? What are the reasons? Now we'll be discussing. The current Chief of Air Staff, Air Chief Marshal RKS Bhadauria, is set to retire on September 30. That means in the same position, actually, who is like holding that office, and next, who is replacing him? So if you see, RKS Bhadauria is a present Chief Air Staff. Is it clear? But now he is replaced by V.R. Chowdhury. Is it clear? Why? Because his retirement is on September 30. So from that office, he'll be moving on. Next, the other person, that is V.R. Chowdhury, is going to replace it. Next, Chowdhury had taken over as the Vice Chief on July 1st of this year after Air Marshal H.S. Arora retired. So previously, V.R. Chowdhury is a Vice Chief of this IAF. Now he is going to become a Chief of IAF. Is it clear? So you can see his image also. Then if we move to his achievements, actually, he is a recipient of a Param Vishisht Seva Medal, Ati Vishisht Seva Medal, and as well as Vayu Sena Medals. So these are the medals which will be representing in the services with the contribution towards the Indian Air Force system. Is it clear? Next, if we move to sports news, Grandmaster D. Gukesh of India wins Norway Chess Open of 2021. So you can see his image, and this is the first point you can see. India, he belongs from India, right? So recently D. Gukesh won his second consecutive tournament of this month. Is it clear? So focus on the part. This is the second consecutive tournament that he has won, is Norway Chess Open 2021 Masters section. And you have to see here actually what is his score. That means in this certain tournaments he has won. Then what is the score of that person? If you see, unbeaten 8.5/10 and finished a full point ahead of the competition with the tournament. So this is the main concept you have to focus here. Is it clear? And why we are discussing about certain person in news? Why? Because the person is from India. Next, if we move to important days. So here, World Rhino Day observed on 22nd September. Actually, here you have to focus first date and then comes to object, right? For what is the date here? 22nd September. Then, if we move to a part, what is that regarding? Actually, this day provides the opportunity for cause-related organizations and as well as NGOs and zoos and members of the public to celebrate rhinos in their own unique ways. Is it clear? You can see the image of rhino also, as you have well known about rhinos, right? So here you have to focus, there were how many like existing species and types of rhinos. Is it clear? So we will look into that. And as a part of this, actually, what is the objective to celebrate this day? Is it clear? What is that? What is the objective to celebrate this World Rhino Day on 22nd of September? Then if we move to the part, this is mainly to raise the awareness among the people that is need to protect the five existing species. What is that? This, while we are selecting like celebrating any specific days regarding these animals or some ecological or environmental issues. So the main objective is to raise the awareness among the people to conserve it and to protect it. So now here this World Rhino Day will be celebrated to protect rhinos. Is it clear? Then this is mainly for the existing species of rhinoceros, which are, you can see now how many there are, total five existing species till now. Is it clear? Black rhino, white rhino, greater one-horned rhino. You can see here what are the like some of the rhinos will be there. Sumatran rhino and Javan rhinos. These are the five existing rhinos. Is it clear? To protect them, at least to get the awareness among the people about this protection, rhinos protection, majorly this day will be selected. Okay, this is the objective. Next, you can see here, World Rhino Day was actually first announced by World Wild Fund. Is it clear? WWF. World Wildlife Fund, that is in South Africa in the year 2021. That means you can see here, and is being observed internationally since 2011. Is it clear? So these are the two areas, and first announcement was done in the year 2010. Then that is again they have observed international. That means now here you can see what is the name, you can see World, that means International Rhino Day, or else you can see like World Rhino Day, actually first observed in the year 2011. Is it clear? And announcement in South Africa was made in the year 2010 by WWF. These are the important areas you have to concentrate in this topic. Is it clear? And in our today's concepts, you have to focus about the Canada's Prime Minister, and as well as you have to focus on electronic park. Is it clear? That means what are the benefits like for establishing and to set up this electronic park? They are promoting electronic industry, and as well as they are giving chance for many national international companies in their state. And the main reason is that they are creating employment for their local youths. Okay, this is the intelligence, you can see how they will be working out in their state. So in the same way, all states should take a step up to create the employment for youth. Why? Because nowadays, so this is the main problem, right? Why? Because like youth will be more, but the employment generation is less. But if you see, if governments are providing certain chances, then even the people and the youth also should utilize it. So if there is like, you can see the cooperation between these two, youth and government, then there will be a success state government. Is it clear? And these are the main objectives and main perspective areas you have to consider in our today's class. And one more thing I want to say, that don't forget to mention your answers in practice questions regarding as Easy Clio, whatever we have discussed in our previous class only. If you are unaware of certain question example, okay? So if you are unaware of that question, then pause the video, go for previous class, okay? So in that class we have discussed all the topics, whatever the topics we have discussed, on the same topics only the next day I'm giving you the questions. Is it clear? Just consider this as a mock test. Even upcoming exams were also there, right? Even SSC, GD, etc. were more exams were there. So this is a time to utilize these practice questions. Consider it as a mock test of daily basis. Is it clear to everyone? So this is the time to end our session. Thank you everyone. We'll meet you in the next class. Until that, stay tuned.